Hello, hello, everyone. How are we today? Lori from Art Lore. Thank you for joining me. Today we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 colors. But I'm only going to do one bloom. And the first color up is Amsterdam Mauve. Real pretty pink. It's going to be a soft palette. TLP Harvest Gold. This green I made, I don't know the amounts, but it was primary yellow, primary red, ultramarine blue. And yeah, I don't know what I did, but because I kept adding and adding and adding one or the other until I got the green that I liked. And that's all Liquitex. This one here is light pink with just a little bit of burnt sienna. And that's also Liquitex. This one here is golden. Quinacridone, yes. Golden quinacridone magenta. But then I added in some Liquitex deep violet because it was too pink. So yeah. All right, we got you in focus. Now I'm hoping I'm gonna move you back just a pinch. I'm hoping that we can do just one nice, big, fat bloom in this 20 by 20 gallery wrap. Forgot to put my pillow down. I get the canvases from Michaels. And it's, like I said, it's a gallery wrap, which I love because I love how it goes over the edges, especially because I do the spinning deconstructed blooms. Got a little something something there. There we go. Yeah, so today, instead of doing the three blooms that I normally do, we're going to just do one. And I've done it before, and I just really like how it looks. So I think this will be kind of a fun palette. I'm running low on paint. And I think the colors are going to pair quite lovely. Because I think that pink and green, that's really going to be pretty together. So I'm just going to use up the rest that's in here. Just kind of go for it here. Okay, good enough. Kind of let those dry out so we can recycle. All right, we're going to start out with a quinacridone first, and I'm going to end with it on top of the mauve, because I want to have I want this color in the center. So here we go. Right in the middle. Then my peachy pink. Just checking. See if you're in focus. It is so pretty. I love this green. You know, I have never been a green person. I just have never liked green, but I am like loving green. With or without bubbles. All right, here's my Yummalicious Harvest Gold. Seems like it's a little thick, but oh well. Okay, so now I'm going to do the mauve. And then I'm going to drizzle my quinacridone on top of that because I just really love this color. and I want it to come through with the cells. My cell activator is always the magical Australian Floetrol and the Amsterdam Oxide Black, and today I'm doing 3-to-1. There we go. All right. High fan, cool air. Okay, pretty colors, I like them. Yes, we do need to let this come up though, because the cells are coming around it, but we need to let that kind of set up in the center, and we are getting some gold, a little bit of green, so that's looking pretty good. So let's let that set up, and then we get to spin. Alrighty, we are back. It celled up so pretty. Very happy with that. Let's just move this. Oh geez, there's a thread. I just went through all the corners too before I put this canvas down, and to make sure that there were no threads. I had to cut a couple corners. And how could I miss that? Okay, we need to fix that. Okay, well that was quick. All right, good, there we go. All right, I know I'm being paranoid, but yes, you are in focus. So, should I draw a couple little lines in there? What do you think? I think I'm going to leave it. We're just going to spin and see what happens. Always hard to stop that. I am going to tip this a little bit this way. Thank you. I'm gonna do it this way. There we go. All right. It's pretty. But I do want to tip it. I can get the seal to break. We're going to go again this way. Oh, that was close. I dipped my hand in the paint and almost put my hand over the canvas. Whew, that was close. Looking good, except I do want this to come off, and I am not having success with that, so we're going to go again. My table is just slammed with paint. Getting there, slow but sure. Yes, I like it a lot, but I want that off. Keep your hands away. So we got to go again. It's almost there. So close. Yeah, I really want that off. Okay, so now what I think I'll do is maybe pull it this way and then pull it this way. I have so much paint on my hands. My hands are so slippery. Okay, so let's give this a try. You can do it. We're almost there. Maybe one more spin because we are just on the edge. See? Just on the edge. But that needs to come off because I don't like the white negative space there because it isn't anywhere else. Why does it do that? All right, I think that might be our last spin. It's like shooting paint everywhere. All right, it did go over the edge. However, there's still a little bit of white space in the corner. So I may have to just live with that. Right there. Right there and right there. But I've got a little bit here and a little bit here, so I guess that's okay. And there's some there and there, so I think it'll be all right. I love it. I think it's really, really pretty. Yeah, it's a really pretty, just a giant bloom smeared all over the canvas. Okay, so let me grab this little bubble here. Actually, it's a big bubble. And there's barely any paint left on the canvas, so that's good. A couple little bubbles here. It's nice to get these when you see them. Cells look great. They stayed intact. I'm very happy with that. Yeah, it's very pretty, I guess, if you will. Okay, so here we go. Take a look at the close-up here. Yeah, it's really pretty. The gold came through very nicely. You see my green cells in the middle are really pretty. They stayed right in the center. It's very wispy, very soft and delicate. I'm very happy with it. Thank you so much for letting me come into your home today, and hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. That would be great. I would so appreciate it. And until next time, bye.